Very good morning, dear children. How are you all? Hope all are you waiting for the class. Today we will learn about the new concept, the poem. Dear children, look at here. Who is this person? Yes, he is none other than Neeraj Chopra. Why he is popular nowadays? He is very young. He got gold medals in Olympics 2020. He is Indian track and field athlete who compete in the javelin throw. He is ranked second internationally by World Athletics. Today we will learn a poem related to the field of athletics. One who shined in the field of athletics, 1956 Olympics Games, given a gold medal to this girl. She is the girl called Golden. Now let's have a great look into the life of the girl called Golden, written by David Batson. Today we will learn the poem about the girl called Golden, written by David Batson. This is the photo of Betty Cuthbert. Now let us have an introduction about the poem. The Owl, a poem in praise of, is written by on Betty Cuthbert by Elizabeth Cuthbert, who was an Australian athlete. She was a great sprinter and had won 3 gold medals at the 1956 Olympics Games in Melbourne. She added a 4th gold medal at the 1964 Olympics in Tokyo. Now we will know about the poet who written this poem. David Batson. David Batson, 1921-1998, was an Australian poet and a photographer. David was well known among the network of children's author and illustrator who met the journalist club at Sydney. Besides writing poems for children, David was interested in ocean theatre and photography. He has published children's poem in numerous magazines and has anthologies or a published collection of poem of his own. Dear children, now I am going to read the poem. You have to listen carefully. While listening, underline the new words. A Girl Called Golden, written by David Batson. Why did you run when your classmates were walking? Why did you sprint if they started to run? Why did you train while others were playing? What was the secret that made it seem fun? Next stanza. Was it the feel of the fresh air and sunshine? Was it the stir of the breeze in your hair? What made the coach recognize you were special? Was it because you had courage to spare? See third stanza. Showing you well when the muscles were aching. Long spells of effort and much to be learned, heeding the words that some others rejected, knowing that winning could only be earned. Last stanza. Time slipped away, then came the Olympics, still in your teens, but spurred on by the cheers, glory at last, as you gain your gold medals, a time to remember the rest of your years. All of you good? Now, again, I am going to read. You have to listen. A girl called Gordon. Why did you run when your classmates, schoolmates were walking? Why did you sprint if they started to run? Why did you train while others were playing? What was the secret that made it seem fun? Was it the feel of the fresh air and sunshine? Was it the stir of the breeze in your hair? What made the coach recognize you were special? Was it because you had courage to spare? Third stanza, showing your will when the muscles are aching, long spells of effort and much to be learned, heeding the words that some other rejected, knowing that winning could only be earned. Time slipped away. Then came the Olympics, still in your teens, but spurred on by the cheers, glory at last, as you gain your gold medals, a time to remember the rest of your years. Now, I have just took some words from the poem. We will see the meaning of that words. Glossary words, Betty Cuthbert, pronounced as Betty Cuthbert. Sprint, to run or go very fast for a short distance. Coach, a person who teaches and trains an athlete or performer. Spurred, encouraged to try harder to achieve something. Spells, a period of time. Heed, to pay careful attention to somebody's advice or warning. Glory, fame, praise or honor. This is what I have listed for you. Do you comprehend with these words? Very good. Now, let us understand the poem easily. See the first stanza. Why did you run when your schoolmates were walking? Why did you sprint if they started to run? Why did you train while others were playing? What was the secret that made it seem fun? Here, sprint means run at full speed over a short distance. Here, rhyming words, I have noticed that walking and playing. Run, train, fun, these are the rhyming words. Now, let us understand the poem. Poet is asking questions with the Betty Cuthbert. Why did you run while others were walking? When your schoolmates are walking, why did you run? And when your schoolmates are running, she sprints. Now the poem in this stanza tells, poet asks, why did the great thought? This is a great way. When her schoolmates were running, she sprinted, was running very fast. When her schoolmates were running, she was running very fast. So, she was ahead of them. when her schoolmates were playing different games, she was getting training for herself. So this is very clear that she was a pleasant personality. She was enjoying running. She wanted to be better at running. This is what in this stanza. Let us understand this by a summary. What is the summary of this stanza? Betty Cuthbert ran when her schoolmates walked. She ran in full speed when they started running. She got trained while they were playing. She enjoyed what she did. What was the secret of her enjoyment? Yes, but she enjoyed what she did. What is the moral of this? What we can understand by her life? Betty enjoyed what she did. It also tells us that what we need to enjoy what we do. This is what in the first stanza. Let us go through the second stanza. I'm going to read the stanza. You have to listen. Was it the feel of the fresh air and sunshine? Was it the stir of the breeze in your hair? What made the coach recognize you were special? Was it because you had courage to spare? Here some glossary words are there. Sunshine means sunlight, stir to move slightly, breeze a gentle wind, coach, trainer, tarabetudara, recognize, identify, hudukudu, spare, in excess, extra. Was it the feel of the fresh air and sunshine? Was it the stir of the breeze in your hair? What made the coach recognize you were special? Was it because you had courage to spare? Here again the poet is giving information about Betty Cuthbert to the reader. Definitely the coach who trained Betty Cuthbert in running, athletics, fast running, found that Betty is special. She was special. What is the speciality of Betty Cuthbert? Feel of fresh air and sunshine? Was it because fresh air around her and sunshine around her? Was that reason she was special? How did the coach identify Betty as very special? It because of extra courage you have. Poet ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ, ವಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ಫೀಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಏರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸನ್ಶೈನ್, ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಕಿರಣಗಳಿಂದ ಅಥವಾ ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಬೆಳಕಿನಿಂದಾಗಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಎನರ್ಜೆಟಿಕ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀರಾ? ವಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಹೇರ್, ಏನು ಗಾಳಿ ಬೀಸುವಾಗ ಕೂದಲುಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಾಡುವಾಗ ಅದರಿಂದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ? ವಾಟ್ ಮೇಡ್ ದ ಕೋಚ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಯು ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್, ಈ ಕೋಚ್ ಯಾಕೆ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ? ವಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಕರೇಜ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೈರ್, ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಕರೇಜ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿಯಾ? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕವಿ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಬೆಟ್ಟಿ ಕಥ್ಬರ್ಟ್ನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಸಮ್ಮರಿ. ಹೌ ಡಿಡ್ ದ ಕೋಚ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಬೆಟ್ಟಿ? ಡಿಡ್ ಹೀ ಫೀಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಏರ್, ಸನ್ಶೈನ್? Or was it because of extra courage she displayed? Let us go to the stanza 3. I'm going to read. Showing your will when the muscles were aching, long spells of effort and much to be learnt, heeding the words that some others rejected, knowing that winning could only be earned. Showing your will when the muscles were aching, long spells of effort and much to be learnt, heeding the words that some others rejected, knowing that winning could not be earned. The glossary word aching, paining, rejected, refuse. showing the will, his mother was waking up. The poet tells, I want to do this kind of sense. Her muscles are paining. When muscles were paining, after long hour of running, she still had willpower. Interest to run, and she still had willpower to practice. Continuous effort and perseverance, she did lot of work to minimize. Let's take back. And much to be learning, she feels that there is much more to learn. She is achieving that if some the coach give guidance to the participant. Students in running, some others rejected, but when as she listened to it, she accepted. Lot of positivity she that had, that the others comparing to others. There was a lot of comparison have a coach. Poet asking about knowing that the winning coach only be earned. She put her willpower in running. She continuously put effort in running. She listened to the advice of the coach. All this she made because she knew that winning cannot come just by luck. It has to be earned. It has to be got with the continuous effort. Lot of confidence, willpower, she was interested also. This is how she achieved. Showing your will when the muscles were aching. Will muscles galige no aadru kuda avara ichcha shakti annodu tumba drudavagittu. Long spells of effort and much to be learned. Heeding the words that some other rejected. Yaar reject maadidru kuda yavudannu keliskolta irlila. Yake keliskolta irlila, knowing that winning could only be earned. Naavu ಜಯವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಗಳಿಸಬೇಕು, ಯಶಸ್ಸನ್ನು ನಾವು ಗಳಿಸಬೇಕು, ಅದಾಗಿ ಅದೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಬರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನುವ ದೃಢ ನಿರ್ಧಾರ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ತು. ಯಾರಲ್ಲಿ? ಬೆಟ್ಟಿ ಕತ್ಬರ್ಟ್ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ಮರಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಈವನ್ ವೆನ್ ಹರ್ ಮಸಲ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಪೇನಿಂಗ್. ವಿಲ್ ಪವರ್, ಇಚ್ಛಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದ ಕಾರಣ ಮಸಲ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ನೋವುಗಳಿದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗನ್ನು ಪಡೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಶಿ ಪುಟ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಅರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್. ಪ್ರತಿ ಕ್ಷಣದಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸುಮಾರು ಇದೆ ಅನ್ನುವ ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವಳು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲು. ಶಿ ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಡ್ವೈಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕೋಚ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವಿಟಿ ವೆರ್ ಎಸ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ಯಾರು ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದವರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವಳು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ವೆನ್ ಶಿ ಲಿಸನ್ ಶಿ ನ್ಯೂ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಕೋಚ್ ಎಡ್ವೈಸ್ ವಾರ್ ಎಂಥೂಸಿಯಾಸಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಿನ್ನಿಂಗ್, ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಿನ್ನಿಂಗ್. ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು ಏನು ಕೋಚ್ನ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನುವುದು, ತರಬೇತುದಾರರ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನುವುದು ಒಬ್ಬ ಆಟಗಾರನಿಗೆ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವ ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಅವರು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ಲು. ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸಿ. ಟೈಮ್ ಸ್ಲಿಪ್ಡ್ ಅವೇ, ದೆನ್ ಕೇಮ್ ದ ಒಲಿಂಪಿಕ್ಸ್. ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಟೀಮ್ ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಚಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಗ್ಲೋರಿ ಅಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಗೇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ the rest of your years. Teen age means age group between 13 to 19, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. These ages called as teenagers. Cheers, expressing good wishes. Slipped away, went away or passed by. time slipped away, then came the Olympics. What happened? After all the effort she put forward, it was the time for Olympics. Time slipped away, time passed away on by the cheers. Between her age group of teen, but encouragement everybody wishes her. Glory at last changed her as a gold medalist. Finally, all her effort paid in. It is the time to remember the rest of years. The moment when she earned gold medal, that was the time to remember in her rest of the years. When it was time to participate in Olympics, she was still a teenager. She is participated. She was spurred by cheers of others. Gaining gold medal was a glorious moment. She would remember the moment of getting gold medal for the rest of her life. This is what in this poem. Have you understood, children? Okay, if you understand, you have to answer the following question. Answer the following questions in a word or a phrase or a sentence. In anyhow, you can answer these questions. Questions are, who is referred to as you in first stanza? Who is referred to as thee in first stanza? What did Betty do when her schoolmates drank? What did Betty do when her muscles ached? Whose words did she heed to? These are the questions. Dear children, take your pen and book and try to write the answers. Have you finished? Very good. Okay, now let's see what are the answers for these questions. Who is referred to as you? Yes, Betty Cuthbert. Who is referred to as they? They means your schoolmates. What did Betty do when her schoolmates ran? When her schoolmates ran, Betty sprinted very fast. And next question, what did Betty do when her muscles ached? She showed her willpower to run. Whose words did she heed to? She heeded to the words of the coach. Yarana alusaristayillo. Let's discuss about the summary of the poem, whole summary of the poem. Betty ran when her schoolmates walked. She ran in full speed when they started running. She got training while they were playing. She enjoyed what she did. What was the secret of her joyment? Next stanza, how did the coach recognize Betty? Did he feel fresh air, sunshine, or was it because of extra courage she displayed? This is what about the second stanza. Now, third stanza, because of her willpower, she was able to train even when her muscles were paining. She put long hours of self-effort, knowing that there was a lot to learn. She listened to the words of advice from coach with positivity, whereas others rejected it. When she listened, she knew that the coach's advice was essential for winning. When it was time to appreciate, in Olympics, she was still a teenager. When she participated, She spoiled bad cheers of others. Gaining gold medal was a glorious moment. She would remember the more moment of getting gold medal for the rest of her life. This is what about the summary of the poem, A Girl Called Golden. Have you understood, dear children? If you understand, let's see the activity. You have to do this activity. Try to write answer for this questions. What are the questions? Did Betty participate in Olympics? Yes or no? What was her age during the time? What was the outcome in Olympics for her? Dear children, hope that all of you understood the poem. To know about the answers, you have to read the poem and try to do the home assignment. For that, what you have to do? You have to read the poem thoroughly. Otherwise, you can't write any one answer from your question paper. Thank you, dear children. Have a nice day.